You're good.
She's right.
Yeah.
Her husband's gonna come back around.
She has her husband. But every father said something, and I don't know what it was, obviously.
So. Rich, I'm sorry, I've been months now. It's after we all say that I father, our father, that's my job. I'm trying to think, when do I start the first reading?
One day, he says a little prayer over here after.
I'm like, no.
There's a glory.
Glory.
After the glory. He said a little prayer there. No, it's a creed, I'm like, it's a creed.
Yeah, see, yours confuses me. It's like, I remember the order, when I'm in it doing it, but it's like, but now it's just, Randy's there, Alex.
Well, he's a lot.
And he's not as fun. He's been doing it all this time.
I'm pretty sure.
On the videos.
I'm pretty sure it's a creed.
It's after that. Yeah, I will. I will. In.
Okay, yeah, it's still going. Okay.
Joe's number two, I think. Joe's number two.
More people coming in.
Yeah.
I got a proposition for you. I know you did. I didn't know Mass was still going on. I thought it was over.
Mass was over.
Well, then I don't have to.
But yes, but you're in church.
It doesn't make any difference. We're in church all the time, decorating and all that. You don't give me that garbage.
Don't be mad.
How many times have we been in here decorating and what have you? Everybody's got hats on.
Our entrance and to fun. O God, who sent your kingdoms of the earth, you kingdoms of the earth, sing to God. Praise the Lord who ascends from the highest heavens, his majesty and might are in the skies. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
We begin our time in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We're very blessed. Because the coronavirus has affected our lives in so many ways that none of us could ever have imagined. Your fast from the Eucharist has been a burden, and we are all grateful to be able to return now to the public celebration of the Mass. However, the pandemic is still with us, and so it is necessary to come back with some precautions in place out of a sense of Christian charity. A concern for the most vulnerable is one of our greatest obligations as a Christian people. And so I ask for your cooperation in following all of the guidelines. Let's keep our trust in the Lord to see us through until our entire community can come back together in Christian worship. Our staff and so many volunteers have done so much to effort to sanitize our church, to make sure that we have all the things we need, and to ensure our safety as best we can, though imperfect, as we gather for Mass. Our Mass is going to feel very different. We will have no singing. The song will be simple with an In the restroom, you will find directions and the necessary cleansing wipes that are needed. To just simply touch up every place you may have touched. We ask you not to hold hands unless you're of the same household during the Our Father. I'm going to be really mean and not give you the opportunity to say you may exchange a sign of peace. It's not in the book. I mean, I can do that. It's in the book. I can do that. And in that way, you won't be tempted to do it. Okay? Communion's going to be very different. I will explain that as you get closer. Also, at the end of Mass, you will then be having the ushers escort you out row by row so that, again, we can maintain the safe distancing. And again, that's very important for the Mass itself. Okay? And so, as we gather, we open our hearts to God, knowing and believing that His love is here for us. And so the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us open our hearts and prepare for the sacred Mass.
Lord Jesus, ascending to the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, sitting at the Father's right hand, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are always with us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens as the apostles looked on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live with us always on earth, and we with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus had did and taught until the day he had been taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power by the Holy Spirit. It comes upon you, and you will be witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up and the clouds took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? announce his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
God announces his throne to shouts of joy,
blare of trumpets for the Lord. All you people clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness, for the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth. God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amidst trumpet blasts. Sing praise to God. Sing praise. Sing praise to our King. Sing praise. For kings of all the earth is God. Sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your heart be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe? In accordance with the exercise of his great might, which we learned in Christ, raising him from the dead, and seating him at his right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet, gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Friday, and it's been fun because everybody's been so out of sync about being at church, and it's not as crowded, and you're not sitting where you normally sit, so a lot of people forget when to sit and stand and kneel, and I'll be just smiling and tell you, okay, you can sit, you can stand, so just be aware of that and just smile with me, okay? It's just part of getting back into a routine. Our gospel today, our celebration today for the Ascension of the Lord, is really very important to us in our faith life. Jesus came from heaven to be one like us in all things, so that we can see how to live his model of love, of trusting in God, and bringing God's love to everyone. We remember in the letter to Philippians where he says, he humbled himself. He took on the form of a slave. He emptied himself for us. And we know that as we celebrated Holy Week and Good Friday, where Jesus completely allowed himself to experience the awful torturous death he went through, so that we would find forgiveness and be welcomed into the kingdom of God. And that has begun now. And we then, for our part, need to remember that as he came back, the disciples were surprised. They couldn't believe it. They were shocked. They were even the readings. You hear how they're still trying to get it together. They're still laughing sometimes that he was actually there. Because it just blew their mind. They never thought of the Lord rising from the dead and coming back and being with us in the flesh. And he ate and drank with them. He had fellowship with them like he had before. And it was just so overwhelming. But he promised that he would go, but he would not abandon us. He promised that he would stay with us always. But now that he has gone to be with God in heaven, no longer does time or space limit Jesus' and God's presence to us. No longer are we alienated from Jesus ever, or from God, because they live in a dimension different than ours, where true life is from. And from there, he's with the Lord. We say it in our creeds, both the Apostles' Creed and the Nicene Creed, that the Lord sits at the right hand of the throne of the Father to intercede for us and to care for us. They continue to share with us. And so when we receive the Eucharist and celebrate Mass, we're part of that eternal moment of salvation in life. And we are blessed in a sacred way because of that. And so I always love that scene of the apostles standing around, and they're watching Jesus rise in the clouds, and he disappears, and they're still looking like, what's going on? And the two angels stand and say, oh, so what are y'all looking at? As a way of getting them out of what they were doing. And then they went and prayed for 9 days, waiting and wondering what was coming, knowing that God was going to do something grand, but not sure. And those 9 days had become our model of novenas, of praying, waiting, expecting that God would be here for us. So this moment of the Ascension really is important for us today, because sometimes we can feel like God has abandoned us. How many times these past few months have you just been downright tired of the isolation and the stuff on TV and on it goes, getting depressed and worn out? On many of the faces of everybody at all the masses this week, it was easy to see them. Just worn out from all that we have to go through. And admitting that it's hard to even pray. As much as you want to, it's hard to do that. The simple prayer is all we have to say. Lord, I trust in you. I'm tired, but I do trust you. The more we remember and recall these gifts, that the Lord is with us, we will find that renewal, that peace, that strength we need, that often gives out during these long, hard moments of life. So God hasn't abandoned us. He's with us in new ways. He's with us in a more powerful way. And do we then remember that truth and turn to him knowing that he is present, even though we feel such distance? We feel it, but it's not true. We know he's with us. He has never abandoned us, because we're his. Let us remember that truth. Let us celebrate that love in our exhaustion. And I ask them for the peace and the wisdom to move forward. And the Lord will continue to bless God and Israel. So as we think about this wonderful celebration of Jesus ascending to heaven, we told Thomas, I've gone to prepare a room for each of us. But he's also continuing to walk with us. Let us always remember that truth, that we are blessed. God has not abandoned us. He's still with us in even a more profound way. Because of our Mass, I would like to say the Apostles' Creed today instead of the Nicene Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He has ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. On this joyous day marking Jesus Christ's return to his Father, we offer up our needs and the needs of those around us.
For the church, that we continue to carry on the commission Christ gave to his first disciples, preaching, teaching, and baptizing throughout all nations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all nations lay down their arms and resolve never again to use instruments of death to resolve disagreements and discord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from systemic persecution, oppression, and discrimination, that justice and righteousness may overcome sin and evil, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those most susceptible to the coronavirus, that God will protect them from illness and surround them with the peace of knowing that they are loved and cared for beyond measure, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have hardened their hearts and have lost hope, that they may realize the love of God that has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in times of illness, our merciful, loving Father will strengthen our faith and trust in his goodness and divine providence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may be blessed with wisdom and hope, so that we may be effective witnesses in our communities of the joy and consolation of our faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parishioners, may we continue to grow in love for God by listening to his word and acting on it, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who have died, to protect and give freedom to our nation, and for their families and loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Generous God, you provide water for those who called you in the desert. You sent your Son and promised water that would always satisfy our thirst. Through the prayers we offer and quench our thirst for your life-giving water, we make this in all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated, ever living, at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You may now kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be added into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Henry, St. Gregory, St. Rob, Blessed Francis Xavier Silos, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
At this time, I'd like to instruct you about receiving communion today. For those who cannot move, the deacon will bring you communion. Everyone else, we ask you to notice, in the front aisle, there is a X that marks the spot. That's where you wait until the deacon is available for you to step forward. Everybody else, notice the pews. You have blue tape. That's how much distance you need between you and the person in front of you. The ushers will try to help you with that, even though they're not going to get in your face, because they want to keep safe distancing too. When you come forward to receive communion, you are to leave your mask on. We're only allowed to receive communion in our hands. Once you receive communion, you will walk to the side. You will see another X on the floor. At that point, you will stop. You will pull down your mask. You will receive communion, put your mask back up, and then make your way back to your pew. Now, if you happen to finish with Deacon Randy before the person in front of you has moved, you are not allowed to go. You have to wait there until the next person has moved on. Okay? Plus, you have the added joy of stopping if you don't have hand sanitizer with you. You need to use the hand sanitizer before you approach to receive communion. Now remember, we need hand sanitizer to continue to keep us safe from anything that we may get.
put on a lot of hand sanitizer, you can't receive communion until your hands are dry. Because it's only when the sanitizer is dry that it's effective. You got it? So we're going to have a very peaceful, prayerful communion with some quiet, lovely music playing in the back, helping us remember God's love. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Help me kneel. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland, and cause us to press forward following the Savior's footsteps to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At all the masses, I asked people what they experienced. And we talked about the Mass, the change in the feel of the liturgy. A lot of people decided they're bringing their own hand sanitizer now. You ever get one? To help keeping things flowing for the communion line. If you don't, that's fine. But it makes it quicker that way. We also realized a few problems where people were sitting, so that people are not too close. I'd like to remind everybody that in our church here, we're supposed to only be sitting on both ends, not anyone in the middle. So if anyone comes forward and they'd like to join you, everyone sits on the ends only, unless there are three of you in a family unit. If you have three in a family unit, then you take the whole pew to yourself. Other than that, everybody just gets the ends. Got it? Okay. These are learning curves. When you come to communion, remember that you keep moving up when the person in front of you has passed the lines in front of you. So you can keep a pace of 6 feet. As soon as someone processes up, then you just join them. A lot of you were really good. You knew not to receive food with your mouthful. So you took your mask off as you received it. We'll work on that too. It's fun watching everybody, because as someone who has a particular type of mask on, it makes me wonder if they've all I see are the bones. So it's fun to see everybody with a different mask. So these are little things. Again, do remember, I want you to pay close attention. After mass tomorrow, we'll decide how many of our weekend masses we will keep. Okay? Because if we continue to have small crowds, for the safety of everyone and for the sake of not having to constantly disinfect the entire building, we might move to one mass. Okay? Heads up. And if you have any questions about this or anything that we're doing, don't feel free to ask, and we'll be happy to get back with you. Okay? Well, let us pray together our prayer that Pope Francis gave us in regards to the pandemic. O Mary, you always shine in our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, help of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of all people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection, seek refuge, O Mary, Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of we who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Please bow your heads as we pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you, for on this very day his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where he is. Amen. May he grant that as Christ, after his resurrection, was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself merciful to you for all eternity. Amen. And may you who believe he is seated with the Father in his majesty know with joy the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Go forth, this Mass is ended.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Oh, it's still recording.
Well, I gave you three.
Well, I know, but there's 100.
We'll take them. Auntie, I'm turning it off.
How do we clean up, Steve?